Very nice. Oh, you're in a tree. Go, Dukes. He's alright.
Yo guys, what's up? You're back with the Skuff Weekly Skid. Pretty big lineup for you today. Our boy Sticko is going to be reviewing a longboarding DVD called Log. We go over to Scotland where UK mountain biking legend G Atherton just took out the World Cup event over in Fort William. We check in with Hawaiian Kokoa Bakalso who just took out the six-star WQS event over in the Maldives. More from Beer Fridge. Ego catches up with JJ from I Killed the Prom Queen. But right now, let's check out Uli Gegenschatz, our Swiss wingsuited madman, where he tried to race a plane over in the Aran Islands, only equipped with a handful of threads. Check it out. Uli Gegenschatz beat the plane by a full 75 seconds, but now we go straight over the channel where G Atherton just took out the downhill mountain biking event at Fort William over in Scotland. Congratulations, G Atherton, but right now straight to the tropics for the Maldives six-star WQS event.
Welcome to the Maldives presents Sri Lankan Airlines Pro at Pastor Point, Chaya Island, Donzelli. This is a prime-rated six-star World Qualifying Series event, and it's regarded as the premier event on the WQS calendar. In the round of 144, we saw small testing conditions, but it didn't stop the likes of Sam Page, Phil McDonald, and Jadson Andre all posting good scores to progress through to the next round.
My name is Mike. I'm from Mali. Surfing is getting more popular within the youth in Mali and also throughout the country. I've been working here in Pastor Point for the last 5 years. I get to surf at my home break with the pro surfers. I'm living my dream.
In the round of 96 of the Sri Lankan Airlines Pro, we had a swell increase with clean 2 to 3 feet waves, producing fun walls and great scoring potential. World champion Sonny Garcia was in great form, as was Australia's own Sean Cansdell, but the wave of the day went to Matt Wilkinson with the highest heat score of the competition so far, including a perfect 10-point score.
I got an 8.8 on my first wave, and then That last one came, it just ran down the end, and I had a few good turns through the beginning, and that end section just sat there waiting for me, and I got that last air in, and I was pretty stoked, felt really good.
Final say at the Maldives presents Sri Lankan Airlines Pro, and what an incredible week with the swell pumping every day. It was the Hawaiian surfers setting the standard in the quarterfinals with Kakoa Bacalso, Joel Santino and Dustin Parker, and the lone Brazilian Leonardo Neves moving through to the semi-finals. Advancing from the semi-finals was Dustin Parker and Kakoa Bacalso, making for an all-Hawaiian final here at Pastor Point.
Hi, I'm Sonny Garcia, and we're off to check out the sights in the capital of Maui. Love is a lesson to all men.
Hi, you did amazing.
We can never make them happy, so just give them the credit card and let them go shop by themselves.
Taking the crown in the final was former ASB World Junior Champion Kakoa Bacalso from Hawaii.
The waves were just absolutely firing, and all the boys were in rhythm, and it feels really good to finally win one, especially at a six-star prime. All my boys over here, that's for sure.
We're really happy for him. You know, he's been chipping away. We've both been chipping away at this for a long time, so it's a good mid-year result.
Coming up next, Sticko's stirring it up with his DVD review of a DVD called Log.
Yeah, Hawaiian domination! Boom!
Howdy, folks. We're here at the headquarters in Byron Bay, chilling out, going to review Log. It's some American job, just about Malibu riders trying to do airs and just trying to do pretty much shortboard riding on Mals. I don't know what the goal is, but I'm more into just chilled out, kind of soulful Mal riding. Joel Tudor has a really good section in it. He's the man. These guys should take a leaf out of his book. Most of it's just these roosters just trying to like belt it heavily on big 10-foot boards. Log is like a stinky bog that should be left in the dunnies or the piss trough. I'm gonna give it 1 star. Wrecked.
Getting it done. The crazy town boys know how to stay at number one. Relax, design a new tattoo. They're getting crazy tats from the crazy town crew. That's what we like to do. That's what we like to do.
Coming up next, getting sideways with the boys from Beer Fridge.
Hooray, Ranga!
Shout and scream. You
crossroads. Stand at the last page and unleash all your know. Fuck all the powers that be. Don't sit there silently. Stand up, shout and scream.
Yo guys, well that's it for another edition of the Weekly Skid. If you like what you've seen, go to the website scuff.tv and download the podcast. Also, there's only been a handful of entries into our Splendor in the Grass ticket giveaway, so get in there. All you've got to do is tell us why you think we should give you the ticket, so get in there, check it out. See you next week. Yo. Ego here for Skuff Music, talking to JJ from one of Australia's finest hardcore bands, I Killed the Prom Queen. How are you, bro?
Not too bad, mate. It's been a long couple of weeks, but I'm doing pretty well.
Absolutely. You're just coming off the back of your farewell tour. How's that going for you?
It's doing awesome, man. It's been really frantic. The shows have been awesome. Kids have been amazing. The turnouts have been, you know, more than we expected. And yeah, everyone's been having a load of fun and couldn't have, you know, hoped for it to go any better. So it's been great.
You guys officially split a year ago now, so the tour was a long time in the making.
We always knew that we were going to do a final tour because we didn't want to, you know, just leave it how we did. It sort of ended like that and everyone kind of dissipated and went and did their own thing. So we knew that something was going to happen, but it was just a matter of when. Everyone's got their own projects. Jonah's living in the States now, touring with Bleeding Through, so it was just a matter of when it could happen, and now's the time.
How was it getting all you guys back together?
We all still keep in touch, hang out all the time, and we always see each other. And you know, so it's been, it's not like we sort of didn't talk for a year and then went, hey, let's jump on a tour. Like, it's all been cool, and everyone was sort of really excited to do it, so it just kind of was a matter of when, and just made it happen.
Now, it's fair to say you guys are, you know, probably helped spawn the hardcore scene in Australia to what it is now. How do you feel about it?
It's a crazy thing, like, it's been, like, 7-8 years or something since we started, and so much has happened, and like the scene's grown so much and gone in so many different directions, and like we just like to think that whatever sort of impact we did have, and like, you know, we hope that people, you know, like what we did, and we hope that there's some longevity to it, and we hope in 10 years time there's still people being influenced by that and still sort of consider us an integral part of the Australian sort of hardcore movement and stuff like that.
You guys gonna get back together?
No. No. Back to what I just said, like with the 7 or 8 years, I think, like, you know, we had a good run at it. We wouldn't have changed anything if we could, like, you know, it's just like a learning process, but everything's got to, you know, come to an end, and we've done it well, I think. Like, we couldn't have gone out in any better way. Like, this tour has been amazing, the responses have been great, our fans have been more supportive than I could have ever hoped for, so yeah, I think this is a pretty good note to sort of leave it on.
And a bit of a treat for fans, I hear that there's a live DVD maybe on the way.
Yeah, we've been filming a bunch of shows from the tour, and we've got one of the guys on tour filming all the antics that go on, you know, on the van rides and after shows and, you know, after parties and all that sort of stuff. So we're going to chuck that all together and make a DVD of that, and that should hopefully be out in the next couple of months.
Well, we're going to check out a clip now from your last album, Music for the Recently Deceased. Say Goodbye, that was released about 2 years ago. It's still charting, it's still rocking out, people are still buying it.
Yeah, it's good to hear, it's doing well. Like, cause, you know, as long as people keep buying it and keep getting into it, you know, it makes us happy.
Absolutely, let's check it out now. Say Goodbye. JJ, cheers for joining us.
Thank you very much.